Hello children, welcome everyone to SV Union High School and Junior College. Our subject today is EVS 2 Standard 5. We are going to continue with chapter number 6, Stone Age and Stone Tools, part 2. Last part of the video we saw children how stone man learned how to shape various stones according to the type of task that he had to do. For example, if he had to dig out something that was buried under the soil in the earth, he had to use something pointed, a pointed stone or pointed stick depending on type of soil. Suppose it was soft, he could use a stick also to remove it. If it was a hard soil, he had to use something very solid, that was stone, pointed stone. So in the last part we saw that how stone man learned to give shape to various stones according to his needs and requirements on basis on various factors like availability of resources, minimal use of time and energy, maximum efficiency, skill of handling tool which is acquired through practice. So in the last lessons we have also learned that human beings were the most intelligent living things on the earth. So due to his detailed observation, keen observation and good experimentation and his imagination, he learned to give various shapes to the various objects. Now in this above slide we can see the chimpanzee using a stone for various activity. We can also see him using a stick to remove ants from the ant hole. It is believed that Homo habilis made stone tools as well as tools from other material. However, of the tools made by the humans, all the tools that are made by the humans, from them, among them, only stone tools are found in the excavation. Tools made from bones and twigs are not found, because twig and bone tools must have got decomposed and vanished. Therefore, they are not found. Only stone tools are found in the excavation. So these are the above slides showing you the various types of tools like chopper made from pebble, a scraper, then a circular hammer stone, a chopper made from a flake of stone, a borer made from bone, an antler used as a pick. Various other articles made from bones like beads and bones and shells are also found in the excavation. The period from which mainly stone tools are found is called as the Stone Age. And this Stone Age is divided into three parts, that is Old Stone Age or Paleolithic Age, Middle Stone Age, that is Mesolithic Age, New Stone Age or Neolithic Age. So we are going to discuss Middle Stone Age or Mesolithic Age in this video. In the Middle Stone Age, the life of Homo sapiens continued to make progress in many, many different ways. They learned to grow crops, they learned to settle in one place, they learned to build their own houses which could protect them. Then apart from hunting, they also started harvesting food grains and grew in the wild, and they also included different types of plants and food in their day-to-day diet. They also began to stay in one place for a very long period of time. The Homo sapiens also learned to capture wild animals, bring them and domesticate them. And the first animal that they domesticated was the dog. They also domesticated sheep and goats. Then they required several different types of lightweight and durable tools for various tasks like hunting, fishing, harvesting of crops, cutting of trees, etc. So they started in developing new different types of implements. The Homo sapiens made tools and knives by firmly fixing a row of blade as small as fingernails into the groove in a bone or a piece of wood. Then several sites of this Middle Stone Age have been found at Bogar in Rajasthan, Bhimbetka in Madhya Pradesh, Lahaganj in Gujarat, Patne Jalgaon in Maharashtra. The above map shows us the location in India. The Middle Stone Age learned to make stone tools by the fluted core technique. Now let us see what is fluted core technique. Flute means a long parallel side depression on the stone, and core means the original stone from which the blades were removed. After the blades were removed from the stone from all sides, the remaining core had such flutes on all sides. Blades removed with this techniques are very minute. The size of the nail are slightly bigger. Hence, they are called as microliths. Micro means very small and lithos means stone. In the Middle Stone Age, arrows were made by fixing microlith at the tip of the stick. You can see it in the picture shown above. It is given in your textbook also, page number 28. A knife with an edge like a saw made by fixing microliths. Then arrows with the microlith as the tip middle, made by the Middle Stone Age. Then the fish hook of bones. These were the different types of weapons that they started making by flute core technique. New Stone Age or the Neolithic Age. This period is known as Stone Age because it is this period that the new technique of making polished stone tools with smooth and shiny finish was introduced. Now they started making tools which were polished, which were scrubbed on each other and which were polished from on the top, which had a very smooth and shiny surface. In the New Stone Age, agriculture and animal husbandry and domestication of animals had become very important means of obtaining food. Hunting, which was very important activity to get food in the Middle Age, had also become less important. In India, a number of sites of New Stone Age are found along the Ganga River and in south of India. This is the picture given of a polished stone axe that was made by the Stone Age, New Stone Age. Then these are some of the polished stones and various tools made by the Neolithic or the New Stone Age. In the last video, I explained to y'all what is percussion technique. We are just going to revise what is percussion technique, children. Now, percussion technique is a method of beating or striking one large pebble against another to obtain stone flakes. Stone flakes are small pieces of stone. Both the Homo habilis and the Homo erectus used this techniques to make the tools. In the old stone age, the tools known as choppers made using this techniques were very crude and had sharp edges on only one side. These tools were made by Homo habilis and used for breaking nuts or bones. I hope, children, that you have followed and understood my explanation in this video. I expect you to go through the lesson, read carefully for better understanding. Thank you very much, and please take care of yourself. Thank you.